हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, सो टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द टाइप्स ऑफ क्वेश्चंस गिवन इन क्वेश्चन नंबर 6 to 10 फ्रॉम एक्सरसाइज 5A. सो आई एम नॉट गोइंग टू डू द एग्जैक्ट क्वेश्चंस इन द गिवन इन द एक्सरसाइज. व्हाट आई हैव डन इज दैट आई हैव मेड सम क्वेश्चंस व्हिच आर सिमिलर टू दिस क्वेश्चंस एंड आई विल डिस्कस देम सो दैट यू कैन फॉलो दोस एंड फिल अप एंड सॉल्व दिस क्वेश्चंस गिवन इन द एक्सरसाइज. सो एज यू कैन सी द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन हियर इज अबाउट व्हिच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग नंबर्स आर नॉट फैक्टर्स ऑफ 36. So you have to find out, some options are given here, you have to find out which of these numbers do not belong in the factors list of 36. That means you have to find out the factors of 36 and see whether these numbers are belonging there or not. And whichever doesn't belong there, you have to circle it. So I've not done this one, I've taken a different number so that you will do it yourself and follow the way of doing it from my examples. So which of the following numbers are not factors of 30? I've taken 30. So you don't need to show the factors, find out the factors and show it here because options are given. We'll just circle the options. So what we'll do is that in rough work, let us find out the factors of 30. So if I find out the factors of 30, so it's 1 into 30, 2 into 15, 3 into 10, 5 into 6. You already know how to find out the factors, so I'm not wasting time there. Now I've written all the factors here, 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 10, 15 and 30. Now let us check whether the options given here belong in the factors or not. So first is 1, so 1 of course will be a factor of 30, which is already here. Next is 7, which doesn't belong in the factors of 30, so I've circled 7. 5 and 2, both are factors of 30, so I've not circled them. Again 8 and 4 are not factors of 30, so I've circled both 8 and 4. 10 is a subfactor of 30, so that is not my answer. 12 is again not factor of 30, and 15 is a factor of 30. So as the question says, you have to circle, you have to find out only the numbers which are not a factor. So that's why I circle these numbers which are not factors of 30. So that is the way how you are going to find out the answer of question number 6. Question number 7 says, write the factors of 24 and 30. Two numbers are given, 24 and 30. You have to write down their factors. For which factors are common to both 24 and 30? You have to find out the common factors. And then you have to write down which common factor is the smallest and which is the greatest. So I've taken a different number here. I've taken the number 20 and 35. So I'll find out the factors of 20 and 35. So I found out the factors accordingly. 1 into 20, 2 into 10, 4 into 5, 1 into 35, 5 into 7. So I've written down the factors of both 20 and 35. So that was the first part of the question. The second part of the question was which factors are common in both 20 and 35. So if I see the common factors here, so there it has two common factors, 1 and 5. There are no other common factors here. So the common factors of 20 and 35 are 1, 5. So second part of the question done. The third part of the question says which common factor is the smallest and which one is the greatest. So as you can see, 1 is the smallest factor here, so the smallest common factor is 1. And 5 is the greatest one, the greatest common factor is 5. Now because I got only 2 common factors, so it was easy to find out. If you get 3 common factors or 4 common factors, so 1 will always be the smallest one. And the greatest one you will get in the answer. Whichever number will be the greatest one, that will write in the greatest common factor. So that is how you are going to solve question number 7. Now question number 8, list all the even factors of 48. Now 48 will have many factors. From there, you have to find out the factors which are even. We know what are even numbers. Even numbers means the numbers which are divisible by 2. Or you can say the numbers that ends with 0, 2, 4, 6, 8 and all these numbers are known as even numbers. Now, I have taken another number, so 36. So, I'll find out the factors of 36. So, 1 into 36, 2 into 18, 3 into 12, 4 into 9 and 6 into 6. So that means these are all the factors of 36. 1, 2, 3, 4, 6. 6 is twice, so I'll count only one time. 6, 9, 12, 18, 36. Now only what you have to do is that you don't need to write all the factors. You have to just write down the even factors. So let us check. All the even factors of 36 are. Now because 1 is an odd number, so it is not an even factor. So I'll not write 1 here. 2 is an even number. So 2 is the first even factor. 3 is again odd, so I'll go to 4. 4 is even, so 4. 6 is even, 6. 6 two times is there, so I'll count only one time this one. 9, which is again odd. But again, if you see 12, 18, 6, 36, all these ends with even digits, so they are all even numbers. So 12, 18 and 36. So what I've done, I've written only the even numbers which are the factors of 36. So don't take the odd numbers, only take the even numbers which are the factors of 36, because that is what the question has asked. So same thing you will do for question number 8 also. You'll find out all the factors of 48 and from there you will write down only the even factors. Next comes list all the odd factors of 63. So I've taken 45 here. So I found out the factors of 45, 1 into 45, 3 into 15, 5 into 9. Now because the question has asked to find out the odd factors. Now if I go through the factors here and I find that all the factors are odd here. None of them are even. 1 is odd, 3 is odd, 5 is odd, 9 is odd, 15 is odd, 45 is odd. That means all the factors will be the answer here because all of them are odd. So all the odd factors of 45 are 1, 3, 5, 9, 15, 45. So what did you get here? That when I find the factors of even number, this is 36 is even number, and when I found out the factors of 36, some factors were even and some factors are odd. There were some factors which are odd. Again, there are some factors which are even. But when I find out the factors of odd number, there are no even factors. All factors are odd. So always remember this. If you find out the factors of even number, some will be odd, some will be even. But when you find out the factors of odd number, all of them are odd. So that is how you are going to do question number 9. You are going to find out the odd factors of 63. Now lastly, the last question. The last question says, what are the factors of 55? Is 55 even or odd? What can you say about the factors of 55? So I've taken, instead of 55, I've taken 35. So what are the factors of 35? Is 35 even or odd? What can you say about the factors of 35? So let me take 35 and find out the factors first, because that is the first question. Find the factors of 35. So I've written the factors. So factors of 35 are 1, 5, 7 and 35. Done. Next question is 35 even or odd? Now it's quite clear. We know that 35 is not even because any digit ending with 5 cannot be even. So that is odd. So 35 is an odd number. So 35 is an odd number. Done. Lastly, what can you say about the factors of 35? So if you look at the factors of 35, as I've just now said, few seconds before, that in an odd number, when I find out the factors, we find that the factors are also odd. So that means whenever you find out the factors of odd number, all the factors will be odd. So what can you say about the factors of 35? All the factors of 35 are odd factors. Okay, so that is the same thing that you are going to do in question number 10. Find out the factors, write whether 55 is even or odd, and then tell whether all the factors are odd or even. So that is how you are going to do all the questions from 6 to 10. I have not discussed the exact questions from the book because I wanted to do it yourself, as I have not scheduled any GMeet for this particular class. So that's why I'm sharing this video, so that with some examples of the similar type, so that you can follow the writing style, how to present the answer. This is how you are going to present the answers. This is the proper way of presenting the answers. So follow all the writing style that I've given here, and then accordingly solve all the questions from 6 to 10. Okay. If any doubts are there, any questions are there, so in the next class when I'll schedule the GMeet, you can clear your doubts there. Okay. I hope you will understand from this video. I have nicely presented all the answers. I have discussed all the points here. So I don't think any confusion will be created here, and you can easily solve the questions given in the exercise. Okay. So thank you everyone. Bye-bye.